What is this ma here? Ismu mausula. What is it? What is the meaning of ma? Allazi. And the mabni is the one which la yatagayyaru. What is it? La yatagayyaru. Okay, brother. No vowel signs. You can put your vowel signs. Tagayyara is madi. Yatagayyaru is mudariya. And where is the file? Akhir. La yatagayyaru. Akhiruhu. The end of it does not change. Bi sababil amili. The agent even cannot change anything. It comes in one uniform appearance. That's all. It has only one appearance. Ji? Bi sababil amili? Nahu. Write down, brother. Yes. Nahu means? What did I write? For example. For example. Inshallah. Ja'a ha'ulai. Brothers and sisters, Ja'a is our fi'l. Where is our file? File has to be marfu. It ends in kasra. Why? Because it is mabni. So here, brothers and sisters, mu'rab means you can relate mu'rab to a person who has got three uniforms. When he goes to the office, he wears suit and tie. Okay? And then when he goes to the playground, he puts on a t-shirt and a short pant and his Adidas. Okay? And then, so when you see him in t-shirt and shorts and Adidas, what do you think he's going to office? No, he's going to a playground. And when he puts on suit and tie, what do you think he's doing? Going to bed? No, he's going to work. But when you see him in pajama, what do you think he's doing? He's getting ready for retiring and going to bed. Now, you won't say the person will go to office in pajama or the person will go to playground in pajama because he has different attire for different occasions. Compared to that, brother and sister, a noun which is mabni is like a poor man. He has got only one uniform. He can go to work in the same uniform, he'll go to play in the same uniform. If he goes to bed, he goes in the same uniform. And if you happen to invite him for walima, he will come in the same uniform. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? So that is the difference between mu'rab and mabni. We have been studying this bit by bit. Brothers and sisters, I have been preparing you for all these things. So nothing is a surprise to us. We have some idea. Alhamdulillah. So how do I describe, brothers and sisters, how do I describe ha'ulai? Okay, you will write down, brothers and sisters, you will write down, if you want to write down in detail, okay. See, ha'ulai is fa'ilun. So what will you say? Fa'ilun. No, you will say fa'ilun. Fa'ilun mabniyun fa'ilun mabniyun ala kasrati. Because every noun which is mabni will end in something. What about haza? Mabniun ala sukun. What about hadihi? Mabniun ala kasra. What about zalika? Mabniun ala fata. Tilka. So haulai? Mabniun ala kasra. Mabniun, fa'ilun, mabniun ala kasra. And then what will you write down? Fi mahali raf'in. That's all. So it's easy, brothers and sisters. Brother Hassan, you will write down fa'ilun. Okay. Mabniun ala kasra. And then fi mahali raf'in. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? This is how you will describe ha'ulai. What is next one, brother? Sa'altu ha'ulai. Now, how will you describe? Mafulun bihi. Okay. Mafulun bihi. Mabniun ala kasra. Fi mahalli nasbin. Got the idea? Fi mahalli nasbin. Fine. Now, I'm sure this business of fi mahali, we are not a stranger to it. We have got used to it now. Had it been like, instead of this haulai, had it been a proper noun, for example, Muhammad, then we would have seen ja'a Muhammadun, sa'altu Muhammadan. See, I would have seen it. Then I would have seen, but because it is mabni, then I have to say fi mahalli. It is in the place of a noun, which should have been dun, dhan, or din. Marfu, mansu, majrur, inshallah. Fi mahalli means it takes the place, you know, in the position of. So, brothers and sisters, sallamtu ala. Ha'ulai. Now, ha'ulai is ism majrur. But it is mabni, brother. Allah came, so I know it is majrur. Otherwise, it has a kasra built into it. The kasra is part of it. So when Allah came, so I know it is ism majrur. So how will I describe? Ismun majrurun. Mabniyun ala kasrati fi mahalli jarrin, inshallah. Is it clear, brothers and sisters? Now I have written here something very important, brothers and sisters. Inshallah, you will make a note of it. Fi mahalli raf'in, fi mahalli nasbin, fi mahalli jarrin. Now, when do you use these terms? When, number one, it is mabni. Number two, now I'm going to show you things here. Number two, shibu jumla. How many kinds of shibu jumla we know? No, jar majrur, two only, brother. And zarf plus mudaf ilayhi. Okay, now I tell you something. You got to listen to me. I may not write it on the board. We have told you many times. Mubtada is always marfu. Khabar is always marfu. Now, when it is one word, we see the dhamma on it. Okay? But when it is jar majrur, it is jar majrur. We know it is shibu jumla. For example, okay, Muhammadun talibun. For example, so what is talibun? Khabar, marfu, sahi. Now if I say Muhammadun fil masjidi, what is jar majrur? Shibu jumla. Now you will write down shibu jumla fi mahalli rafa'in khabar. Because it had it been one word, it would have been marfu. But because it is shibu jumla, we don't see that way. We see shibu jumla, jar majrur, shibu jumla, and what will I say now? Fi mahalli raf'in khabar. Are you with me? Because khabar is always marfu. And same way, Muhammadun huna. Muhammad is here. Are you with me? Or Muhammadun hunaka. He is there. Okay, so what is huna and hunaka? Zarf. As soon as you say Zarf, brothers and sisters, so what is it? Shubh Jumla. Shubh Jumla. Zarf. Shubh Jumla. And then what will I say? Fi Mahalli Rafa'in. Why Rafa'in? Because Khabar is always Marfu. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Khabar is always Marfu. Sahih, brother? So then, this is how we describe. Now, brother, we did not do before. Now we are in advanced study of Arabic language and Arabic grammar. And it is very beautiful, very logical, very fascinating. I was amazed. You know, I did not find these terms difficult because it makes a lot of sense to us. The only thing is, because they are new, it will take time, day or two, to get used to it, inshallah. Now I come to Jumla, brother. Jumla, what is Jumla? Okay. Now, a sentence can also have a position in the in the whole construction. Are you with me? We are going to learn more about it later. But in order to give you a simple example, brother, I'll stick to Mubtada Khabar. Okay? I say Muhammadun Zahaba ila al Masjidi. Let me write it down. Inshallah. Muhammadun Zahaba ila al Masjidi. But this is a very simple explanation. We will have little more complex sentences coming. But when they come, you will be more prepared to take it. And I write down another sentence, brother. Muhammadun I put a line. What is the meaning of line? Mubtada. MashaAllah. Okay, brothers and sisters. Look at the first sentence. Muhammadun Mubtada. But where is the khabar? No, we have to write down. Zahaba fi'l madi. Okay, now I will say Mabniun ala fata. Where is the fa'il? Damirun, mustatirun, taqdiruhu, huwa. And if you want to go a little further, you'll say Yadullu ala Muhammad. It goes to the, indicates Muhammad. Okay, brother? And what is ilal masjidi? Jar majrur, jar majrur, khalas, nothing more, jar majrur. Now look at it, brothers and sisters. Where is the khabar? It is a whole jumla. So what will you say? Al jumlatul fi'aliyatu fi mahalli rafa'in khabar. Before, we did not use these terminology because you would have been totally gabarified. And you would have said, it's too difficult. But now, inshallah, you will comprehend it. So what will you say, Sister Madina? Zahaba ila al-masjidi, which is al-jumlatul fi'aliyatu fi mahalli raf'in. Why raf'in? Because khabar is always marfu. Fi mahalli raf'in khabarun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Inshallah. Now we say Muhammadun. What is Muhammadun? Mubtada. Where is the khabar? Leave aside Muhammadun on one side. Now you go to Akhuhu Tabibun. What do you see? Akhuhu. What is Akhu? Yeah, but before Mudaf, Mubtada. What is Akhu? Mubtada. Wahuwa Mudaf. And what is who? Mudafili. Fine. Where is the khabar for Akhu? Tabibun. Okay, now this whole sentence, what kind of a sentence is this? Al-jumlatul ismiyatu fi mahalli rafa'in khabar. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Inshallah, you got it. But, Sister Sumayya, if we are not 100% sure, don't worry. Lesson number 8 or 9. You know what is that lesson? Do you want to know what is that lesson? Mubtada and khabar. Again, Mubtada and Khabar will come in detail. Yes, Brother Salim?
Yeah, yes, but in this sentence, Muhammadun Akhu.
Who?
Akhu, who? Two Mubtada there.
We cannot say two muktadas. Yes. Muhammad is Mubtada, then we are taking the whole sentence separately. Now if you want, you can do another way. Muhammadun, Mubtada number one. Okay. Akhu, Mubtada number two. And then brother and sister, you will describe Mudaf, Mudafili. And what is Tabibun? Is the khabar for what? Mubtada number two. So it is khabar number two. If there is a muftada number two, then there has to be a khabar number two. And then you will say the whole jumlatul ismiyatu, khabar number one. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? You can say that also. Huh? And you can say in a different way that I explained to you, brothers and sisters. We have a book called Nurul Yaqeen, which is grammatical analysis of each and every word in the Quran. And inshallah, you will see how they describe it. And we can follow that process of description, of grammatical analysis, later on, brother and sister. So brother, a jumla can also be fi mahalli rafin, it can be fi mahalli nasbin, and it can be fi mahalli jarrin. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Okay. Now, we come to al-mastar al-mu'awwal. Brother, we are expert in this. Huh? We are expert in this. For example, brothers and sisters, Uridu an ashraba shaya. I want to drink tea. Uridu fi'lun mudari'un marfun bidamma. Fa'il mustatir. Taqdiruhu ana. An ashraba an harfu nasbin. ومستريين. And what is أشرب فعل مضارع منصوب بالفتح. Where is the فاعل؟ مستتر تقديره أنا. And أشعيا is مفعول به for أشرب. Okay. But where is the مفعول به for أريد؟ If I say أريد, I want what? I have to have a مفعول به. So what is مفعول به؟ المستر. Al-mu'awwal. Then what will I say? Fi mahalli nasbi. Now you are already used to it. So then you know where to use these terms. But remember, brother, yumkinuka an tajlisa huna. So where is the file for? So what will you say? An tajlisa al-mastar al-mu'awwal. Fi mahalli. Now you will say rafain. Are you with me? So you will see how these three things are explained. Now, brother, this is very important. Fi mahalli rafa'in, fi mahalli nasbin, fi mahalli jarrin. And these are the four categories in which you will be using them. And brothers and sisters, this is very easy. Today, it may seem to be a little overwhelming, but don't worry. In 2-3 days, inshallah, you will find that it is very clear in understanding, inshallah. But these things are not difficult. These are easy, but it can be a little overwhelming on the first day. Do you get the idea, brothers and sisters? Did you write it down, everything? Inshallah. Keep these notes handy. Because when you will stand up to teach, brothers and sisters, you got to explain all these things. Then the students will find learning Arabic a very enjoyable, interesting, and it is fun. Brothers and sisters, we go forward now. Al-Mu'arabu means declension. Wal-Mabniyu, non-declension. Minal-Asma'i, in the nouns only. Al-Asma'u kulluha. All the nouns, brothers and sisters. Mu'arabatun. They are all declinable. If you wish to write, all the nouns are declinable. All of them. Ma'ada. Now what is the meaning of ma'ada? Except. Write down this word also, brother. Ma ada means illa. What is the meaning of that? Except. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Ma ada. Illa alfiatil atiyata. Except the following groups. What is the meaning of alfiatu? Groups. What is the singular? Fiatun. What is it, brothers and sisters? Fiatun. What is the meaning of fiatun? A group. And al-fi'atu means groups. Except the following groups. Brothers and sisters, this is all revision. Trust me.